Hello, I'm Aida, and I'll show you how to do smooth zoom in, zoom out, and parallax effect in Alight Motion. Zoom ins and zoom outs are simple, yet there are so many ways to do them. Using the scale property, using nulls, using the camera ins, the axes, and using effects. Basics. A zoom in is entering the clip with a zoom, and a zoom out is exiting the clip with a zoom. Normally, we just animate the scale from movement transform. We add a keyframe for the normal state, then increase the scale at the start of the clip to make it zoom in. However, scaling your character up using the scale property can feel slow. So instead, use a null layer. I'll first get rid of the scale animation, then add a null layer. Take a clip, tap on the parenting button, and set the null layer as the parent. The null layer controls your clip, and animating its scale property will feel much easier and smoother. Look how easy it is to scale up your character now! The zoom out animation can be animated the same way. Just keyframe the normal state a bit before the end of the layer, and increase the scale at the end of the clip. Null layers also help keep the original layers intact. Removing animations off of an original layer is a pain. We are currently zooming in from the chest. I want to zoom in from the face. How do we do that? Head to the location property, tap on the location icon to activate the pivot point, and move the pivot point to the face. As you can see, we are zooming in from the face now, but I want it to look a bit better. To control the position it is starting from, I will animate the location property. I'll make it start from a different position before coming to our default position. It works now! Graphs. Our zoom animation can be made even smoother using animation easing or graphs. Using ease out easing for zoom ins and ease in easing for zoom outs creates an amazing loop. I'll get rid of the location animation to show only the scale animation. Tip: if you have multiple animated properties in the same direction, find whatever graph you set for one of the animations. Copy it and use it for animations in that area or duration. This will help keep things smooth and avoid awkward mismatched movements. These are the basics. If you exaggerate the curve like this, you'll get even faster zoom animations in half the time. I find that the ease in out graph creates a very eye-catching smoothness. It demands attention more than the others. This easing creates a softer flow, and I see it used by a lot of people too. This easing is usually used for a single animation over the whole layer, rather than for startings and endings. Now we know the basics, animating the scale and using graphs. Let's learn the camera way to animate zooms. Camera and Z axis. We have our clip, no need for nulls. This time the camera layer will animate our zooms. Add a camera layer. Then activate the camera view. This will help us see what our zooms will actually look like. Go to Move and Transform. Now you can animate the scale property the traditional way, or you can animate the Z axis. From the location property, tap on the Z value, then swipe up or down to increase or decrease the zoom. This will work normally unless you have more layers and you adjust your z-axis values. As an example, I'll first put a few shapes around the character. It scales up as usual with no individual Z-axis adjustments. Now, I'll adjust the Z-axis for the individual layers. By adjusting the Z-axis for the individual layers, I am bringing some shapes behind your character and some in front of our character. The shapes you put in the front will move faster and the shapes behind will move slower, just like real-life parallax effect. If you play the animation now, it'll have a parallax effect. It'll move according to their Z-index order. Next, let's get into animating zooms using effects. Animating zooms using effects. A replacement for the move and transform scale property is the raster transform effect. It has a scale property you can animate, just know that it won't work on camera layers or nulls, only on groups and layers. But it's a good alternative if you don't want to touch the layer scale property and don't have parenting, which is premium. One effect I like for extra zooms in the middle of a zoom is the pulse effect. When you add the pulse effect from the move transform category, it is animated by default. You'll have to set the frequency to 0, then animate the grow property to create zooms. The grow property has limited zooming, that's why you should pair it with null or scale animation to create higher range zooms. You can also add an oscillate effect and a swing effect to give your edits more of that crazy zoom look. Motion blur. Adding the motion blur effect from the blur category will automatically apply blur upon movement. You can adjust the tune property for greater or lesser blurring. That's about it. I hope I didn't miss anything. Bye-bye!